Good morning, my dear students. So today class we are going to discuss about the most important theory for the columns, that is the Rankine's theory. So in this chapter, still now we learned the Euler's formula, okay, and it was good. It is giving good results only for the very long columns. But what happens to the short columns and also very not column is not long. So for that type of the columns, on the basis of the results of experiments performed by the Rankine's, so he's a researcher, and also he established an empirical formula which is applicable to the all columns, whether they are short or long, whatever it may be, short or long. Okay, they performed and also they developed a empirical formula. The empirical formula is given by Rankine. That's why it is called as a Rankine formula. I will write now that formula is nothing but 1 by P equal to 1 by PC by 1 by PE. So this is the formula. Here P is nothing but, I will write clearly, crippling load by Rankine's formula. And PC is nothing but crushing load, that is sigma C into A, okay? And also sigma C equal to ultimate crushing strength. And A equal to area of cross section. And also PE is nothing but crippling load by Euler's formula. That is nothing but pi square A by LE square. Here you know LE is the effective length. So this is the empirical formula developed by the Rankine. That's why we call it as the Rankine formula. That formula is nothing but 1 by P equal to 1 by PC plus PE. 1 by PC plus 1 by PE. So here, P is nothing but crippling load by Rankine's formula. PC is the crushing load. So the formula is sigma C into A. That is the stress into area. Sigma C is the ultimate crushing stress. And A is the area of cross section. And again, PE is nothing but crippling load by Euler's formula. Okay. So here PE is nothing but pi square A by LE square. We know already this formula. The LE is nothing but effective length. So this is the formula. So for suppose if you take any type of the column, the material of that column, the crushing stress sigma C is the constant. Hence the crushing load, whatever it may be, the PC value here, okay, it is equal to sigma C into A. So it is also a constant for a given cross-sectional area of the column. Okay. In this equation, if you see in this equation, whatever we are observing here, when PC is constant and hence the value of P, whatever this P value, when the PC is constant, the value of P is depends upon only PE. Okay. But for a given column of the material and a given cross-sectional area, the value of PE, it depends upon the effective length of the column. You see, if you observe here, PE value, it completely depends upon the effective length of the column. Now, for suppose, if the column is short, so what happens? That means the effective length is very small. So when the effective length is small, what happens? The PE value is large. So based on formula, whatever we wrote previously. So what happens? The value of 1 by PE here, it is only enough, and also it is negligible as compared to value of 1 by PC value. So now we have to neglect the PE value. So what happens? 1 by PE equal to 1 by PC. So if you reciprocate this one, what happens? P equal to PC. So that's why the crippling load by Rankine formula for the short column is approximately equal to the crushing load. That means P is the crippling load of the crippling load by the Rankine's formula of the short column is approximately to the crushing load, that is a P equal to PC, when the column is very short. Same like that, when the column is long, what happens? So here, when the column is long, that means the effective length also large. So then the value of PE will be very small. Okay. And also 1 by PE value is a large enough compared to the 1 by PC value. Okay. So hence the 1 by PC value here, the 1 by PC value have to neglect. Then what happens? 1 by P equal to 1 by PE. If you reciprocate this equation, P equal to PE. That means the P is nothing but crippling load by Rankine's formula for the long columns is approximately equal to the crippling load by Euler's formula, P equal to PE. So these conditions we got, and also the Rankine's formula, whatever we wrote, that is 1 by PE equal to 1 by PC plus 1 by PE, it gives the satisfactory results for all lengths of the column, the ranging from short to the long columns. Okay, it will give the good results also. Now the Rankine formula is 1 by P equal to 1 by PC plus 1 by PE. So if I write like this, the next step, PC into PE. Now I reciprocate this equation. What happens? P equal to PC into PE by PE plus PC. And again, now I divide with the numerator and denominator with the PE. What happens? PE C 1 plus PC by PE. So I will write again here. P equal to PC by 1 plus PC by P. So now we know already PC is nothing but sigma C into A value. And also PE is nothing but pi square EA by LE square. Okay, now I substitute here. PC is sigma C into A by 1 plus again sigma C into A by pi square EA by LE square. Okay, so here we know already the I value. The I value we know, capital A small square, K square. Here K is nothing but least radius of variation. Okay, so the above equation becomes, but suppose if I substitute into the above equation, the I value, the above equation I will write once again, that is a sigma C into A by 1 plus sigma C into A by pi square EA by LE square. Now I substitute here sigma C into A by 1 plus sigma C by pi square into A by E into LE square by A K square. Like this it happens. Now sigma C into A by 1 plus sigma C by pi square E. Here A and A cancel. Multiply by LE by K whole square. Okay, now the final value, the load, whatever we got, the Rankine's formula load value is sigma C into A by 1 plus A into LE by K whole square. Here A is nothing but sigma C by pi square E. It is also known as a Rankine's constant. Okay. This is our Rankine's constant. And also this equation, whatever we calculated still now, the P value, it is a crippling load by Rankine's formula. This is the P value is a crippling load by Rankine's formula. And the Rankine's formula is a empirical formula. And also A value is taken from the experimental results. Okay. Anyway, this is the derivation for the Rankine's formula. And also now we will solve one problem, very easiest problem, okay? The first problem is, I will write here, the external and internal diameter of a hollow cast iron column are 5 centimeters and also 4 centimeters respectively. Okay, so now if the length of this column is 3 meters and also the condition is both of its ends are fixed, this is the condition of the column. So now we have to determine the crippling load by using Rankine's formula. Take the value of sigma c is 550 newton per mm square and also Rankine's constant is 1/1600. So this is the formula. If you observe in this formula, the external and internal diameter of the hollow cast iron column is 5 centimeter as well as the 4 centimeter. And if the column of the length is 3 meters and also the condition is both ends are fixed here. If you observe here, both ends are fixed. And now we have to determine the crippling load using the Rankine's formula. So here take sigma c value is the 550 newton per mm square and Rankine's constant is 1/1600. Now we will solve this problem. Okay. Solution is, first we will write the given data. The external diameter they given capital D equal to 5 centimeters, same like that the internal diameter small d equal to 4 centimeters. So what happens, area of this column is pi by 4 into capital D square minus small d square, that is pi by 4 into 5 square minus 4 square. So if I write this one, if I solve this one, I will get the answer 2.25 pi centimeter square. If I convert into the millimeters, that I will get 225 pi mm square. Okay, this is the area. The next, moment of inertia. I equal to pi by 64 d power 4 minus small d power 4. Here pi by 64 into capital D, we know external diameter 5 minus small d is 4 power 4. So if I calculated this one, I will get the answer is 5.76565 centimeter power 4. If I multiply with the 10 power 4 for the conversion of the millimeter, so I will get answer like this. So this is the moment of inertia. We got the value. The next, we have to calculate the least radius of variation. That is nothing but small k equal to square root of I by A. I is the moment of inertia and A is the area. So I, we got just now the value is 5.76565 and area is 225 multiply with the pi. So once if you calculated this one, we will get the answer 25.625 mm. Okay, this is the least radius of gyration. Now you see the length of the column they given already in the problem. The length of the column is, you know, that is L equal to 3 meters, that means 3000 mm. Okay, as we know the column is, the condition is both the ends are fixed. So both the ends are fixed here, the condition. So the effective length for this condition is L equal to L by 2. L is nothing but 3000 by 2, we will get the answer 1500 mm. Okay, and also the crushing stress already given in the problem, the crushing stress equal to, that is a sigma c, the value is 550 newton per mm square. And also they given in the problem is Rankine's constant. that is a equal to 1 by 1600. Now we have to calculate the crippling load capital P, that is a sigma c into a by 1 plus a into le by k whole square. This is the crippling load calculation formula by the Rankines. Okay, I will write again and we will substitute the all values. Sigma c into a by 1 plus a into le by k whole square. So here sigma c is the 550, a is the 225 into pi by 1 plus a is 1 by 1600, and le is the 1500 effective length, and also small k is 25.625 whole square. So if I calculated this one, if you solve this here, so you will get the answer this one, 123,750 newtons. So this is the answer, and this is the crippling load by Rankines. So these problems are very easiest problems. Once if you solve the problem step by step, what is the given data? First you have to calculate the area, then moment of inertia, then least radius of gyration. So after that, what is the length column condition? So from that we will go through the Rankine's constant and crushing stress, they given in the problem. We know the Rankine's formula, so substitute all the values here, you will get the crippling load by Rankine's formula. So moving to the next problem, so I will write the next problem here. Please look, observe here. A hollow cylindrical cast iron column is 4 meters long with both ends fixed. So here, if you observe here, the condition is the fixed condition. Okay. Now we have to determine the minimum diameter of the column if it has to carry a safe load of 250 kilonewton, with a factor of safety is 5. Okay, the factor of safety value is 5. Now they given a condition, take the internal diameter equal to 0.8 times the external diameter. Okay, now take sigma c equal to 550 newton per mm square, and also Rankine's constant is 1 by 1600. So my dear students, if you look into this one, this is the problem. Okay, and here we have to take a hollow cylindrical cast iron column. You see the length is 4 meters. Again, the condition for the column is both ends are fixed. If you observe here, the both ends are fixed here. So now we have to calculate the, we have to determine the minimum diameter of the column. And also you see, if it is hollow, there will be definitely capital D and small d. That is nothing but external diameter as well as the internal diameter. Okay, so how to calculate both? Now it has to carry a safe load of 250 kilonewtons. The factor of safety is 5. So the load is 250 kilonewton as well as the factor of safety is 5. And they're given a condition with respect to the diameter. Take internal diameter equal to 0.8 times the external diameter. So while calculating or solving this problem, first of all, how to take the internal diameter small d equal to 0.8 times the capital D. So like that, you have to take the condition. And sigma c, they given already, that is nothing but 550 newton per mm square, as well as the Rankine's formula, a equal to 1 by 1600. Okay, now we will solve this equation. The first one, length of column, yes, wait for a while, I will write the given data. The length of column L equal to 4 meters, that is 4000 mm. And end conditions, I will write all the given data. End conditions are both ends fixed. okay, and also effective length. What is the effective length? L e equal to L by 2 if the both ends are fixed. So L, we know that is the 4000 by 2, we got 2000 mm. This is the effective length. Now say float, that is nothing but 250 kilonewtons, and factor of safety is 250 kilonewtons. Sorry, factor of safety is 5. Sorry. Now let us take the external dia. The external dia equal to capital D here, and also the condition is for the internal dia is 0.8 times the external diameter. And also the crushing stress, the value for the crushing stress equal to sigma c equal to 550 newton per mm square, and value of a, that is the Rankine's constant, 1/1600. So these are the values given. This is the given data of the problem. Now we will enter into the solution. The factor of safety, the formula is crippling load by safe load. So here the factor of safety we know, that is a 5. We don't know crippling load, that is unknown factor. The safe load they given, it is a 250. So the crippling load is p value equal to 5 into 250. We got 1250 kilonewtons. So if I convert into the newtons, that is a 1250,000 newtons. So this is the crippling load calculation. Okay, now we will calculate the area of the column. The next step is area of column, that is a equal to pi by 4 d square minus small d square. Then the small d is the internal diameter, that is nothing but 0.8 into capital D whole square. Okay, once if I solve this one, I will get the answer like this, pi into 0.09 d square. This is the area of our column. Next, moment of inertia. I equal to pi by 64 d power 4, 0.8 into d whole power 4. This is the 0.8, d is the small d. Okay. So once if I calculated clearly, how it will happen, 5 by 64 d power 4 minus, this is 0.4096 d power 4. So what happens, I will get the answer is 0.09225 into pi into d power 4. This is the moment of inertia value. Okay, so now we have to calculate the formula for I. We know already capital I equal to moment of inertia is A into small k square. So here k is nothing but radius of gyration. This is a small k, radius of gyration. We know that already small k equal to square root of I by A. Okay, so I value is nothing but, just now we calculated, we got the value, that is 0.00925 into pi d power 4 by area. Also just now we got pi into 0.09 into d square. So this is a small k. So once if you solve this one, you will get the answer is 0.32 t. okay, this is the radius of gyration. Now we have to calculate the Rankine's crippling load, the p value, that is nothing but sigma c a by 1 plus a into le by small k whole square. Sigma p, just now we calculated, that is 125,000 in newtons. Sigma c they given in the formula 550, and the area just now we calculated, that is the pi into 0.09 d square. Again, 1 plus A is nothing but 1/1600, and LE is the effective length, 2000. L is nothing but 2000 by small k. Just now we calculated that is 0.32 d whole square. Okay, so that is nothing but if you send the whatever the values here. So once if I calculated this one, I will get like this. I will write clearly here again 1250,000 by 550 into pi into 0.09 d square by 1 plus 24414 by d square. Then again 8038 equal to d square by d square plus 24414. I think everyone knows how to calculate this one solving the equation. Okay. So finally I got d power 4 minus 8038 d square minus 1962 39700. So finally we got this equation. So now from this equation, we have to calculate the D value, capital D value. That is the unknown factor here. And also this is the axial diameter. Now this equation is a quadratic equation in D square. Okay. The solution is the roots. We know the formula for the roots. I will write again for your better understanding. That is minus B plus R minus square root of B square minus 4AC by 2A. Everyone knows this one. Now I substitute here in terms of d square. What happens? 8038 plus or minus 8038 square plus 4. A is 1. C is 1962 39700 by 2. Okay. A is nothing but 1. So if I calculated this one, you see the d square value, I will get 18592.5 mm square. So the D value is square root of 18592.5. So D I will get 136.3 mm. So we got capital D is the axial diameter, that is 136.3 mm. This is the axial diameter. Capital D equal to 136.3 mm. Now the internal diameter. Small d equal to 0.8 times capital D. So 0.8 into 136.3, we will get 109 mm. These are the diameter, whatever